Welcome back to another Dungeon Coach Dungeon Master Breakdown. This is session 32 of Curse of Strahd, and this is very interesting because I'm filming this video after I know that the campaign is ended. Session 32. Wait, how does it end? What's that? It ends next session. What? What? Wait, how? How do they end Curse of Strahd where we're at? If you've been following this series, how on earth do these players at eighth level, at this point in the game, it's way too early. How do they kill Strahd? It's wild and maybe one of the craziest Curse of Strahd stories ever. So stay tuned for that video. It's going to be a much, much different video and a whole thing. So this is session 32. Last session, they figured out, they fought off this massive tree and they figured out that Davian, their fated ally, and along with some of his family members, is about to be sacrificed and summoned and killed to destroy the holy symbol of Ravenkind. So a symbol from a good deity it has sunlight. It's the source of Wereraven, the Wereraven's power. Very, very important artifact, even more so with all the extra homebrew, lore bits that I've added in there. So they are on their way. And here's one thing that I added, and this is ironic to look back on it because I was trying to elevate the danger of the world now that, if you're also unfamiliar, one of my players made a pact with Strahd. And one of the benefits of the pact with Strahd is that enemies and monsters in the area kind of stayed away from them. So whenever they traveled through the world, it wasn't quite as dangerous. The vibe, that presence of Strahd kind of kept them all away. It was super nice. But then the bard broke the curse that Strahd had put him under, broke the pact that he agreed with, and he freed himself. But now it's a lot more dangerous. So when they're traveling, I had this big, huge gnoll fight that we did. We did a big gnoll fight, and I wanted to really get across how dangerous the world was in the travel bits of in between. I also implemented a new kind of skill challenge-y type system where when you travel from place to place, instead of like having a combat, we have to do a combat every time, they're going to have certain types of rolls, and then they might lose some health or lose some hit dice and all this other kind of stuff, just to kind of wear them down a bit. I introduced a new mechanic when traveling to get worn down a little bit. I could probably make a whole video on that type of thing. But yeah, so I introduced all these things just for the campaign to end the next session. So anyway, they're on their way. They had a little fight there and they're getting to the Druids of Yester Hill, and they get there at the very end of the session. We have this big, huge scene where there's this big ritual surrounding the base of the tree that just uprooted itself and attacked the city. There's this massive crater and there's vines reaching out to the center, holding in together Davian and his two family members in the center. And wrapped around the neck of Davian is the holy symbol of Ravenkind, and it is being... The goal is for it to be destroyed. All these druids, there's one arch druid leading the ritual, and there's a bunch around in a circle. I put out a battle map. There's a whole big circle thing. They try to sneak up to it on two different sides. They try to do a silence situation, and the combat started. So how this whole thing worked is a little bit of a, any sort of combat, you want to have some sort of curveballs in. You don't want to just have a kill them before they kill you. So we had this big ritual that was being performed, and they could choose to interact with the ritual itself and try and stop the ritual. They could try and there's obviously casters, having some sort of channeled magic and energy towards this ritual. They could try and save the people in the ritual to try and remove them. They could try and hack down some of the vines. They could try and kill the druids around. Lots of different options. But here we go. We had this big, huge fight. How it ended up working out is actually really wild. The bard was at the front end with the arc druid, so it was almost like a showdown between the bard and the arc druid. Now, arc druid 1v1 would kill the bard, so that was kind of a rough spot for him to bite off a little bit more than he could chew. Meanwhile, the paladin and cleric mounted on horseback together in one horse are charging through counterclockwise. I guess that would be clockwise. Around the circle, killing after druid. Druid just taking them down. Fires wreathing around them as they're divine smiting fire blast. Like, it's kind of crazy. All the way around the circle. Leading to get back to the bard, because the bard was in some trouble. Because the bard was invisible, but then he got found out. And it's now like a little 1v1 against the arch druid as they're coming around. But what's the rogue doing? The rogue, who's the most roguey rogue I've ever even heard of. The rogue is also a wereraven. So what the rogue did is he flew up in raven form into the top of a tree, he cast invisibility on himself, flew up into the top of a tree, positioning himself just so. okay, what is he up to? What's going on? What is he even doing? Next round of combat's happening. Raven's turn, the rogue's turn. He flies into the center. I just got chills. He flies into the center where Davian and his family is, and he lands on the shoulder of Davian, whose necklace is right there. And he's like, can I get it? And I was like, oh my God, okay, yeah, okay. Is he going for the necklace? That's crazy. And I was honest with myself as a dungeon master. I did not describe the necklace as being like wrapped down and vined around. Oh, you can't get it. There's vines everywhere. No, it was just on him. They were constrained. But I was like, I'm gonna stay honest and stay true to my description. Yeah, the holy symbol's around his neck. The ritual is to kill it. And you're going to use the life essence of Davian and his family to kill it or to break the medallion. So he got the medallion. He used his little bird talons and pulled the medallion up off your bird beak, whatever. You get the idea. Got the necklace off of Davian and then flew away. Wait a second. That's the whole point of the ritual. That's the key that the ritual is focusing on. The ritual then has to stop. So then now the druids are shifting over to try and stop and regain the thing they're trying to destroy. Arc druid comes. Just perfect timing. As the bard gets off a spell, the paladin and cleric all come to the arch druid. Bang. Done. Dropped him, dusted. They put the holy symbol inside the bag of holding as the druid falls and the ritual's done. And then also, just a little dungeon master tip here. There was like two or three, I think there's two more ritual people. I stopped the combat there and I was just like, how do you guys end it? The whole thing. And so then they got to describe like how they would end the combat. And I would challenge you guys, try it out. don't feel like you have to, okay, well, there's two more left. Let's keep going. And then you roll that out all those turns, like you guys won, you beat the combat. How does it look? How do you strike down the archdruid? How do the other two fall? You can describe that you capture them and then interrogate them, or you can describe that you kill them. Turns out the bard had just cast from some other homebrew druidy type nature god deity stuff, polymorphed himself into a ape and just goes and smashes him. Done. It was a super cinematic way to end it, and they got the holy symbol of Ravenkind and saved Davian, and they now stand atop Yester Hill, victorious. And that is where the session ended. And interestingly enough, we were supposed to play the next week after that. We play every week, but we were supposed to play the following week. Then some stuff came up, and we weren't able to. I had a whole bunch of things, you know, life happened, right? And so then I was like, I had some more time to prep, and I was like, You know what? What would be funny is what if I had Strahd come, you know? Because like we're at a point of the campaign, we're 32 sessions in, they're pretty powerful, they just got their second holy symbol. You know, I'll have Strahd show up. I'll have Strahd, and Yester Hill's important to Strahd. He can see his homeland from the top of the hill. So I was like, you know what? This would be a good place for Strahd to come and kind of like have that final talk with the villain. They've had such a great relationship with him. They've bonded with him so much as far as you could with a BBEG, as far as respect, not necessarily friend bonding. It's more so like mutual respect for each other, right? So I was like, you know, this will be the last time he comes down and gives them a speech and just talks to them about the end. And all, you know, it was just the final little villain back and forth that they would have with him until the next time would probably be in his castle throwing down. So I thought it'd be a cool thing to have him kind of fly in, kind of talk to them, all that kind of stuff. And because of that, is how we end the session, or how they kill Strahd next session. Strahd arrives, and I just got chills again. Strahd arrives, they have some crazy wild plan that they throw at Strahd. They convince Strahd to do something that only they could convince him to do. They tap into all of the different role play niches of his psyche and the different triggers he has, and they know him so well because they've engaged with him so well. And some crazy stuff went down, and it's as absolutely wild. So stay tuned for next week on that, and we'll tell the story of how Strahd von Zarovich falls out of nowhere. So stay creative. Think outside the box. Peace.